30 but 17 pairs, a modern-day sleeping beauty with a not-so-handsome prince. In fact, he's downright scary, for now. A series of misunderstandings, both past and present, are at the heart of the story, underpinning how easily life can take a detour. Filled with unique and eccentric characters, 30 but 17 follows the recently awakened heroine as she navigates a whole new world. Episode 1, La Campanella, The Little Bell. A teenager begins a sketch and explains to his young nephew that the subject is a girl who's piqued his curiosity. A montage of scenes reveals that the boy, Gongwoo Jin, Yoon Chan Young, perks up whenever this girl crosses his path, and he adds that he plans to use the painting to ask her to be friends. The girl in the sketch is a talented violinist, and an audition reveals that her name is Woo Seo Ri, Park Si Yoon. Woo Jin later sees the name tag on her gym clothes, unaware that they actually belong to her friend, and thinks that Seo Ri's name is No Soo Mi. As he completes his painting of Seo Ri, Woo Jin narrates that this small mistake deeply affected both of their lives. Years later, Woo Jin, Yang Shei Zhong, has grown into a man and sits on a beach where he stares at his painting. He looks at the moon through his fingers, just as Seo Ri used to do, and when a bell rings, he turns around with a smile. Young Seo Ri skips up some sidewalk steps, a moon-shaped charm with a bell swinging from her backpack. She happily studies her music along the way and just misses running into a barricade, saved at the last minute by her friend, Soo Mi. She scolds Seo Ri that she went home in Soo Mi's gym clothes again. Seo Ri opens her bag to return the clothes, but all she finds is a cute little dog. Soo Mi affectionately warns her friend that the music college in Germany will cancel her acceptance if they ever realize how spacey she is. A boy appears in front of them with a bouquet of flowers and proposes marriage to Seo Ri. Hyung Tae promises to master German in the 2 months before Seo Ri's departure so that she won't be alone in Germany. A teacher grabs Hyung Tae and reminds him of his poor test scores as he pulls him away from the girls. Woo Jin greets his nephew at a bus stop with a noisy kiss on his cheek. When an elderly woman rushes for the bus, Woo Jin delays the driver to give her time to catch up. As the bus drives away, his nephew points out in an ad for a painter, but when Woo Jin looks across the street, he sees that Seo Ri is about to get hit by some dishwater. He yells out, "No Soo Mi," and Seo Ri stops and turns just in time to miss the water, but she doesn't see Woo Jin, who's hidden behind a wall. Woo Jin boards his bus, and as it pulls away, he notices a banner announcing a redevelopment meeting in his neighborhood. He's interrupted with a question about the correct stop for the art hall and looks up into Seo Ri's face. Woo Jin jumps to his feet and manages to stammer out the directions. After Seo Ri sits down, he realizes that it's the perfect opportunity to give her the painting, but he can't seem to muster the courage. Woo Jin suddenly realizes that Seo Ri will probably get off at the next stop and rushes over to advise her to remain on the bus until the second stop. Seo Ri is surprised when Woo Jin blurts out that he knows her. He opens the container with the painting of Seo Ri while he explains that he's not a weirdo. He's interrupted by Soo Mi, who just boarded the bus and asks Seo Ri if they know each other. Flustered, Woo Jin manages to jump off of the bus at the last minute. Woo Jin watches the bus pull away in disappointment just as big raindrops start to fall and a bell rings. Seo Ri's backpack charm got caught on the painting's container when he jumped off of the bus, so Woo Jin runs after it just as a huge storm moves in. A truck with a load of tires cuts in front of the bus at the same time that the tarp holding them down comes loose. Tires bounce off of the truck and trigger a multi-vehicle accident, and Woo Jin watches in horror as the bus weaves wildly, soaring into the air when it collides with a car. Seo Ri and Soo Mi are thrown apart before the bus lands on its side and skids to a stop in front of Woo Jin. Seo Ri's bell rings when Woo Jin clutches it tightly in shock. At the hospital, Seo Ri's aunt cries on the phone to her husband and wonders why he's not there. Hyung Tae runs in the rain, and when he collides with a woman and falls, he leaves a tennis shoe behind. Seo Ri's condition looks grim as the doctors shock her heart. A dazed Woo Jin walks slowly in the rain while news of the accident is broadcast on a jumbotron and names No Soo Ri as one of the deceased victims. He thinks back to his suggestion that Seo Ri stay on the bus for an extra stop and believes that he's responsible for her death. A backpack charm slips from his hand as Seo Ri flatlines in the hospital. 13 years later, a camper in the Alps runs into a very hairy, scary-looking Woo Jin in a large fur coat, with a familiar little dog. Back in his camper, Wu Jin offers the dog, Dio Keigu, some dinner, and in the background rests the tube that holds his painting of Xiao Ri. At Hope Rehabilitation Center, a young nurse gasps when she learns that the now-grown Xiao Ri, Xin Hai's son, has been in a coma for 13 years. She imagines that her family must be exhausted, but the senior nurse explains that they never visit a common situation in a long-term facility. The senior nurse confides that an anonymous benefactor sends money to the hospital to pay for Xiao Ri's care. There's also a man who visits from time to time, but he's not the one who sends the money. As the young nurse wonders about the identity of Xiao Ri's visitor, a doctor calls out to Dr. Kim Hyung Tae in another hospital's neurosurgery department. The doctor asks Hyun Tae to take over his volunteer assignment overseas so that he can stay with his pregnant wife. When Hyung Tae ignores him and walks away, the doctor yells out, "Did you take the exam 4 times to become a doctor? That's so selfish." Hyung Tae agrees to take the assignment if the doctor will once again approach the chief with his request. The doctor explains that a university hospital won't accept long-term patients unless they have important connections, and wonders who Hyung Tae wants transferred to the hospital. At the rehabilitation center, the young nurse calls out to a man as he peeks into Xiao Ri's room. He runs off and she wonders if he's her mysterious visitor. A concert is held for the residents of the center and music drifts into Xiao Ri's room after a cleaning woman opens the window. As the woman mops, the sun bounces off her watch and onto Xiao Ri's eyes. When the cleaning woman takes a break, familiar violin music drifts into the room and Xiao Ri slowly opens her eyes. Xiao Ri realizes that she's in a hospital and remembers her accident, but thinks that it happened the day before. In her 17-year-old voice, Xiao Ri wonders about her aunt and uncle and Sumi. Her worries are replaced with fear when she realizes that she can't move a muscle or make a sound. The cleaning woman returns and shuts the window, shocked when she sees that Xiao Ri's eyes are open. She runs from the room screaming, "She's awake! She's awake!" The nurses stand by as a doctor examines Xiao Ri, who manages to utter her name. Xiao Ri's eyes are drawn to a mirror and she asks about the lady that's staring at her. When Xiao Ri is alone with the nurses, she tells them that she was in an accident the day before, but the senior nurse gently explains that she has been in a coma for 13 years. The nurse emphasizes that it's a miracle that Xiao Ri woke up and encourages her to focus on rehabilitation. Xiao Ri can't accept that she's 30 years old and asks the nurses to prove it to her, so they hold a mirror in front of her face. The face that stares back confuses Xiao Ri, who insists that she's only 17 as tears fall from her eyes. The nurses update the doctor, who explains that Xiao Ri is in shock. He asks if they managed to contact her visitor, but the senior nurse admits that there was no answer at his number and adds that he hasn't visited in a while. The younger nurse informs the doctor that Xiao Ri asked about a friend who was in the bus accident with her. Everyone is shaken when the nurse confides that the friend died in the accident. Xiao Ri lies in her bed and remembers the day she and Sumi heard that their homeroom teacher was getting married. She recalls how excited they were that their teacher finally managed to get married at the age of 30. Xiao Ri also remembers that Sumi was worried that her friend would become an accomplished violinist while she would end up a middle-aged woman with kids. Xiao Ri looks at her reflection in the hospital window and grieves for her lost youth, unable to hold back her sobs as she struggles with the reality that she's now 30 years old. Episode 2, Where Are My Uncle and Aunt? A Skype call wakes up Wu Jin in his camper, and when he looks at his laptop, his boss, Hee Soo, jumps in fright and announces that he looks like Bigfoot. She scolds him for